We want our homes! We want our homes! We want our homes!
We want our homes!
Stop gentrification!
Stop displacement!
Stop gentrification!
Stop displacement!
Stop gentrification!
On stolen, occupied native land. Yeah. Whose laws? My people, we had laws and ways of being that ensured that we didn't end up with homelessness crises like we have under United to say, hell no, we won't go. Hell no, we won't go. Hell no, we won't go.
Hell no, we won't go.
Hell no.
Thank you, Audrey. We're going to hear from Tracy Morrison, who's come here all the way from Maple Ridge. She's been holding down a tent city there, although that one is now also dismantled. Tracy, it's an honor to have you here tonight.
Last name is Scott.
Tracy Scott. I don't know. I know Tracy Morrison. That's another person.
Hi, my name's Tracy, and I'm here on behalf of the street population of Maple Ridge.
Yeah.
You know, I'm going to start out with this. Tent city saves lives. But we had an opening statement when we started our tent city, and the city wouldn't print it. We had East Van come in and print it for us. And people think that we just want something for free, but you don't. Not necessarily for free. So I'm just going to recite that for you so you understand a little bit about where we were coming from. We walk the streets day in and day out. We scrape, eat, and survive, because that's what it's all about. The city only wants to throw us away, but we're human, have feelings, so why can't we stay? We take the fall for all the wrong, as we have rights and we stand strong. We're women, we're children, we're sick, and we're old. We need to be heard so we won't fold. We fight for our rights with equality for all. Together we stand, united we fall. We open our hearts and minds to see that there's not much difference between you and me, the family of humanity. I wrote that 10 minutes before Tent City started, and I did that for so they'd understand us. Tent City saved lives, you know. Instead of being scattered all over the town, right, we became one big family, and we helped each other out. So, you know, like if you're hungry, right, the tent across from you is going to help you eat. You're not out there stealing or doing more crime to survive, right?
And they should be thankful.
They don't understand that that's why you do it, because you need to survive. I've been out there, so I know, right?
Yeah.
And I made a pact that I wouldn't stop fighting until it was over. So I'm still standing and still fighting for Maple Ridge on behalf of the Ridge Street population. You know, what you're doing is really good, and I'm hoping that, you know, it's something that we need to do together. I said this in Victoria, and I'll say it again. The government stands as one across Canada against us. One by one, they can take us down. But if everybody goes out and supports everybody else, okay, we stand as one, you stand much stronger to get what you need. So keep up the good work, okay, guys? Thanks.
Thank you, Tracy, and thank you for coming all the way from Maple Ridge. In Maple Ridge, there's been a lot of hatred against homeless people. People throw bottles, people try to drive over homeless people, they point guns at homeless people, but that problem is not unique to, you know, Maple Ridge. It's happening everywhere.
Tent cities create communities after these people have been pushed upon so difficult, so hard by our system that's a capitalist system that Audrey has reminded us is based on the theft of stolen, of native land. Our society is so sick that it's decided now to push out the people who have been most marginalized and most oppressed literally onto the streets, to the curbs, into the alleys, into the alcoves, underneath tarps, people living under on cardboard boxes. And apparently normal society can think that's just fine, that that's a natural consequence and that's just the way things are. Well, it's not the way things are. That's the consequence of choices that have been made by people who have a great deal of power and money. And we know that very well because they're building their homes on top of us, literally. As Ivan showed us when we walked down the street, they're building condos in the downtown east side, displacing people and creating a greater and greater homeless crisis in a city that should have none. At Vandu, we're about saving lives. It doesn't matter if you have an addiction, if you have an illness, if you have a mental illness, if you have other kinds of illness, or if you're, it doesn't matter where you are, we accept and love you as you are, where you're at that moment. And that's what tent cities are about finding a community and creating a world that you want to live in, even though it might be small and it might be rough. It's about creating a world that's yours, because you belong to this world, and you're part of this world, and you might be pushed to the margins, but you're loved.
You're loved. I don't have much more to say other than to thank you all for coming, and to thank you all and remind us all that we're here because we love each other. Thank you.
We're just going to hear from Lama Magabo, who's been part of the Our Homes Can't Wait Coalition, which fought for social housing at 58 West Hastings. And although the city has committed to housing on that site, they have not committed any funding, and so that's still outstanding. But Lama will talk more about that.
Onto the streets because of greed. See, what happened was that 30 years ago, the provincial and federal government stopped building social housing. And as a result, attracting so many wealthy people to Vancouver, they buy these SROs, flip them around, raise the rent. And a unit that was costing $375, $450 is now renting for $1,500 per month. This is not acceptable. We want to keep downtown inside a low-income community, but we also want the federal and provincial government to build dignified housing for people. We don't want SROs infested with bed bugs and rats and inhuman conditions. We want people to live in dignity, and we want them to build housing that's fitting for human living. And we know what we're gonna do come May 9th next year. Don't we know that?
Yes.
We're gonna come out and vote.
Yes.
And vote for the government that's listening to us, listening to our demands. See, what they don't understand is that this unity, this solidarity saves lives. When you live in a tent, like a tent city, you have the support of your neighbors. You help each other. You're unified against those who want to do you harm. And we also know that if the city wanted to help, they wouldn't have put the injunction and kicked us on the streets, but they would have accommodated us, knowing that this is a temporary solution for the housing that we want. So once again, solidarity, we want housing, not shelters. We want dignified homes for people. Thank you, and power to the people. Power to the people.
Power to the people.
Power to the people.
Power to the people.
Thank you all.
Thanks, Lama. All right, we're gonna wrap up and people are gonna set up their tents. There's some food coming in later on, but if there's people here who wanna support this tent city in the coming days, that'll be really crucial. The cops are gonna come and they're gonna try to take it down. So we need supporters. So we need supporters who are not homeless and organizations to come and endorse this tent city. So let me know, or one of the other organizers or someone staying here, that you wanna support it and we can get you on the call list. Please stick around if you want to. All right, thank you all for coming.
Alexander Way. I don't care. Great idea.